It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1581, recorded July 28th, 2016. This crap bombs! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we got some stuff from a sweet, sweet the blogger bash. I have my last Bluetooth gadget, and it is very crappy, and a brick phone from a viewer, all coming up next on The Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for The Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing LEDs. Get ready for The Giz Wiz now.
Time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the master of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir. And you?
Doing great. I'm ready for another fantastic Giz Wiz.
All right, well, let's do this one first,
okay.
And then we'll do a fantastic one
after
right
this.
After it.
Yeah, I think anticipation is key.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
You know, a minute ago, just before we started taping the show, you were talking about returns. I did my first ever Amazon return.
Have you ever returned? You've never done an Amazon return?
No. Normally, everything is like under $10, and like, you know, just finding a box is too much trouble. But this thing was I was doing a thing for ABC on the history of LEDs and LED thing, and Amazon had this light thing, so it was one plug into the wall, but then it had three drop lights, and I thought, well, I can put a plug adapter into each one of these devices, and then I can only have one plug go into the wall, and then I can have three things on the demo. Anyway, it worked like for 3 minutes and then just died. And it was $30.
Yeah, no, get rid of the app. Take that thing
back.
Yeah,
and I thought, you know, so I went on there and it says you have a drop-off location at 96th Street. And it turned out that Dennis had to visit someone on 96th Street. So have you ever gone to the drop-off center thing?
No, I've never done that.
So it says go into the supermarket on 96th. Then says, "Oh, I know the supermarket." So he goes in, and it's a big wall, like an ATM.
Uh-huh.
And all you do is you walk up to it, you hold the box up. He was afraid. He said, "You know, I bring my glasses, going to type in all these little return codes." You hold it up to a scanner. It reads the return authorization. He says, a door pops open. There are all lockers with all locked doors. And a door pops open. And it goes up to the door. And the thing is too big to go in the door. So he doesn't know what to do. So he walks back to the terminal. And there's a little button that says, is the door that opened too small?
And he says yes.
He says yes. And that door closes. And a bigger door opens. And he throws the box in there, and it locks. And 3 days later, I got an email that my item was back, and I had been refunded my money. So it was great.
They
can only take things up to 12 inches by 12 inches by 12 inches, because when they send you the label, it says the thing you're returning to a drop-off location cannot be big. No dimension can be bigger than 12 inches. But it was great.
That's fantastic.
And what do you mail yours back?
Yeah, so I have to. Yeah, so I wanted to buy some shoes pretty badly, and so I on Amazon Prime Day I bought a pair of shoes. I normally wear 9.5s. So I came in, they were much too small. So went through that process, and that was fairly easy. I could print out a label. That I just slapped on the packaging that they sent me and shipped it off. They paid for shipping. They paid for everything.
Oh, great. Okay.
But I had another yeah. shoe disaster. I wanted to buy a different pair of shoes. And so I went for these shoes right here. You can see.
Oh, they're nice.
Yeah, I liked them a lot. They're nice gray, white, and sort of a brown up there. But when I added them to my cart, I noticed a little weird glitch that they show up as a very orange or brown shoe. They don't look like the correct shoe that's on the actual product page, which is, if I click add this to my cart, I'll now have two of them in my cart.
And there was no drop-down menu, right?
Well, there was, but the drop-down menu actually changes the look of the shoe. So let's say I wanted this black one, you know, or whatever. But yes. I chose Kathy Spice / white, okay?
Wow.
So that's the one that I wanted. But it adds to the cart. Well, lo and behold, the one that was shipped to me was that very orange shoe, or brown, I don't know. Not the one that I want at all. And so I had to ship that back. But the problem is that this shoe was not sold through Amazon.
Oh.
It's sold through their marketplace. So I had to pay $20 to have it shipped back so that I could get my $80 returned to me for the shoe. Yeah, and that is very frustrating.
Yeah.
Very frustrating.
So the lesson there is if the photo does not match exactly.
Right.
You know, there are problems with Amazon. I think we talked about that. The What the Heck Is It gadget last month was a pair of things for raking leaves. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people just got one of them because... And I think I said when mine came, it was wrapped with tape, and it said two of them is one
make
item.
Sure, you do two. Yes, exactly. Yes. There's so whenever notes and stuff.
Yes. So I do worry sometimes, and I've had that happen. Also, it's I hate it when you don't look carefully and you order something. It says choice of colors, and you go, God, these sweat socks are nice. I want them in black though for some of my thing, and they're $5 in white, and you click black, and then you suddenly realize they're $9.
Oh yeah, because the color changed. Absolutely.
Yes.
That's very frustrating. Yeah. Yeah. You gotta stay on top of your Amazon purchases. Yeah. You gotta make sure that you're really looking at everything. I've also accidentally shipped stuff to the wrong address a few times. Because, you know, I was shipping something to my parents' house so that it would be there, like, you know, on a trip or something, and then forget about it. And two weeks later, you order something else, and you just quickly, and now it's shipping to my parents. And I'm like, oh, no, I got to go back and cancel that
order. The person who ordered that big poster of Chad, if you got a pair of orangey shoes... We apologize.
We're sorry.
In advance.
Absolutely. Anyway. So let's go ahead and jump in to our show.
Okay. You're right. The show is called Sweet Sweet. The first sweet is S-W-E-E-T because there are tons of sweets at this event. And the second thing is sweet because it's like a suite of toys. And it's a yearly event. And it's Blogger Bash. So they team up with a group of bloggers. These are like bloggers who have large followings. And Blogger Bash is a two-day event, but part of the Blogger Bash event is coming to this Sweet Sweet event, which is all mostly, a lot of them are tech toys. And it took place on a ship. And they carefully tell you in the press invite that the ship will not move. I mean, the ship moved because it's on the Hudson River down at 42nd Street, but it did not leave the pier. And if you go to my website, Chad, there's a quickie little picture. It is the company is called, I forgot the yacht, whatever it is. But this is their biggest ship, and there it is. So what it is it's a huge atrium. So there is the giant floor. They rent it out for weddings and stuff. There it's set up for a formal event. But the entire main floor is toys, and then the two balconies are all toys. And every floor had a food station.
Wow. It was,
yes. The ship is 210 feet long with a beam of 67 feet. So that is a big yacht.
It's called the Majesty Yacht?
The Majesty Yacht.
Wow. That's cool. So, that's amazing.
So Yeah, it is. It was great fun. So we're going to start with something techie for kids from Thames and Cosmos. And here's the first gadget.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're at Thames and Cosmos, and that is probably the first time. Did I say it correctly?
Perfect.
Okay, perfect. We stop here every year because they have great stuff. And now they have GeckoBot. Andy is going to tell us about GeckoBot.
Yes.
Well, first hold it up.
And as you explain it. So this is GeckoBot. GeckoBot is a mechanical robot that children will build. The kit comes with 176 building pieces, comes with a 24-page manual, and throughout the process of following the manual, kids will build 7 different models. The featured model is this GeckoBot. The kit itself teaches about air pressure and suction and the physics of air pressure. It teaches about a little bit about biomechanics, so how machines mimic the way animals move. The really cool thing about this product is that it will walk up a wall.
Now that we want to see. You can stop talking. You can show us.
Turn it on. You can see how it sort of moves in unison. There's a series of ballasts and suction cups and air valve releases. So we're going to stick it onto the wall and hope it walks.
I like the "and hope it walks" because
yes, that was kind of strange. Like, a little bit of progress.
I think I can. Yeah, this one's a little slippery. We could probably even try it on the window over there and see it a little better.
Okay, let's do that. We're going to do a quick wipe and we'll bring you next to the window. We're at the window now. By the way, we're on the Hudson River. And here we go. GeckoBot take 2, walking up a ship's window.
That's pretty cool. Even though it's sliding down a bit.
It is walking up the wall.
Yes. But
he's
walk actually
on any kind of flat surface,
he's sort
smooth
of
flat surface
sideways.
Like a mirror or a
he
window.
Seems to be making more progress.
See, it's getting
side.
Its bearings. It's getting its grip.
And what does he sell
closer
for?
And closer
it's a $50 retail.
A $50 retail, and is it out now?
It'll be out in about 3 weeks.
Okay, and the kit is called just GeckoBot.
Just GeckoBot.
GeckoBot, and your website is?
Thamesandcosmos.com.
Thamesandcosmos.com. I almost said it right 2 times. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv and on the Hudson River. Ahoy, matey.
This seems like something really fun to make. It seems like it could even be like a science fair project almost.
No, absolutely. and it does. The GeckoBot is kind of the flagship model to build, but they have a crawling inchworm, a suction tow truck, a window cleaning
a
robot. Yes,
a suction gun. Yeah, they have all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, so you can build any of 7 different devices. Yeah, I think kids would get a lot of fun, and I love those little tubes and you know, putting air in a cup and then releasing the air. It's a clever, very clever kit.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's also funny. I love the alternative, like, extra add-ons. Like, kids are going to learn about biology through building a gecko. It's like, okay.
Yes, yes, yes. They will learn more about the color green.
Mechanical. Yeah, exactly. It's like, okay, it's a little bit of a stretch. I mean, it's kind of cool on its own, but I guess you're going to throw it.
I have one of those next week, a thing that...
It's like, you're selling this a little bit too hard.
Yes,
like, I get it. It's a robot. You know,
they want everything to fit
in. Your kids are going to make sure to graduate college because
an engineer.
Yes, exactly.
Right. And now the final question to get your master's degree. What's the name of an animal who can climb up windows? Oh, gecko!
Oh, GeckoBot!
If I never built a GeckoBot, I never
would have known. Thank you, parents, for spending $59.99 on me when I was younger. Is that the price? I don't even remember. What was the price?
$49.95. And usually when it gets into mainstream, they'll knock probably $5 to $10 off that. But, yeah, it's a fun gadget, and I like the fact that you can do 7 things with the one model.
Right, absolutely. They even have a little video. I don't know if we
It's a little, I think it's just a 30-second. Oh, it's there. We call these sizzle reels.
Oh, yes. Yes. Dun dun dun. It goes up walls.
Gears turning.
Now, do you think that's a drywall? Could he go up drywall? Or is it just like glass surfaces, do you think?
It said very smooth surfaces.
Very smooth. Not textured wall.
No, definitely not texted wall.
It's neat. Okay, that is GeckoBot.
GeckoBot. Okay, now the Extreme Cycle Moto Cam. No, this is another, kids are going to love this too. And here it is. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Madness Rider, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. We see Extreme Cycle, we see motorcycles, we see cameras. We're very interested. And Kelly's going to tell us about MotoCam.
Yes, hi.
And what is MotoCam?
So Extreme Cycle MotoCam is awesome because it's an RC motorcycle that actually has a built-in helmet camera. So when you're, you know, riding around in the RC, you can actually capture footage in the moment, like you're doing stunts and flips, and you can capture all that on camera. And what's really great is there is a gyroscope in the back. So this cycle will always right itself. So no matter what, you do a jump, rough terrain, you turn around, it's always gonna right itself. As you can see.
Grab that video there.
Oh. Yeah. So it's really, really awesome. Nonstop action. We're really excited about this one.
This is really great. And are we using our remote control with a phone?
Yeah, so the great part is that you have this controller here where you can start and stop video. And then what happens is there's an SD card that's actually hooked up to the bike that you can upload.
Well, you know, I'm going to stop you for 1 second. So the video we're seeing here is someone shooting a video of the motorcycle.
Yes.
Right. And then in the corner, we saw what the motorcycle guy is.
Exactly.
That is really, cool. Really great. Yeah. And I love the fact that if it falls over, it rights itself. Now, this has got to be on the expensive side.
$79.99.
Oh, my word.
Yes.
And is that out now?
This will be out in the fall, so early September.
So a Christmas gadget.
Yeah, definitely.
That is really great. Dennis, do one more shot as I close of this TV screen up there, because there you see the little guy driving, and then when another picture comes up, that's what his helmet cam is seeing. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Madness Rider, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Oh, I love this. We're at Blogger Bash 16. Sweet, sweet. Ah! This is Dickie D driving. Bye.
That's pretty cool. You see, GoPros on motorcycle drivers all the time, so now you could have your own on your RC car, and that's a very competitive price.
It really is. $80 cool. Bucks, and yeah. So I mean, it's not HD quality. It's the video is 640 by 480 VGA. But I love the fact that you can see it here, like go crashing around.
Wow.
It has a little gyroscope in it that stands it back up again. So you get the little ramp, you get the remote control. The remote control has start and stop video on it. A rechargeable 9-volt battery in the motorcycle itself. And then the remote control uses two, I think it was AA batteries. Comes with a 4 GB SD card for a half hour video.
So it comes with that.
Yeah.
That's great. Oh, that's fantastic.
That's great. Yeah. The only thing is, as you watch the video, you realize for $80, you're not going to have image stabilization.
No.
So it's bouncy when it goes through grass or stuff. But when the motorcycle is moving along on flat ground, the video quality is good. And I think kids are just going to love this.
Yeah, that definitely seems. Anything with a camera, I mean, as a kid, it felt like you were a spy. You could do anything.
Yes.
You know, you send it around the neighborhood and catch bad guys with it.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly. Send it into the kids' room and see what they're up to.
Right, exactly, yeah. Exactly. So that looks way neat. For $80, you get not only an RC car. It's not only a car. It's a motorcycle.
It's a motorcycle.
You don't got to worry about it.
And a camera.
And a camera. And you don't have to worry about it falling over, which is pretty cool.
That's right. Yeah. And it's a gyroscope, a self-righting gyroscope.
I guess it's technically Wicked Cool, as that's the name.
Wicked Cool is the company, exactly.
The company. That's
the company.
That's Wicked Cool. I like that. The extreme cycle moto cam.
And our final gadget is going to be great for parties. And I think toys kind of skewed toward boys and girls. I think girls are probably going to like this toy better. But at a party, everybody's going to like this gadget.
Hello, man's maddest writer and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at GizWiz.tv. You know, I take my work very seriously. I don't do anything foolish, but now I'm going to put on a fake mustache. This is what I look like with a mustache.
Wow.
And this is without the mustache. Okay. So we have something really neat here. When I walked by and I saw Katie with this.
So the selfie mic is awesome because every kid wants to be a YouTube star, right? So now they can. And who doesn't love selfies and karaoke? So it connects directly to your phone, and it works with the partner app Star Maker, which has over 3 million songs you can sing. And once it connects, this turns into a working microphone. So we can all do a music video together, and we can add filters to our faces and also auto-tune our voice, because I'm not really a good singer, so that's great.
I'm a zero singer.
All right, so right now we're going to sing Miley Cyrus. So you press record, and then the song will start playing.
Oh, you know these words, Dickie D, right? I mean,
it'll straighten out your singing.
Uh-huh, yes.
Okay,
yes.
And you can also play it back on your phone if you want.
It saves it to the phone. Yes.
And when is this coming out?
This will be out next month for the holidays.
Okay, and we're taping this in July. It'll be out in August.
August.
Yep. Okay, and it will retail for?
$24.99.
You see, I'm a professional. Not attached to a selfie stick.
It should be.
Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at GizWiz.tv. You know what? Honesty in broadcasting, this is not my own hair. Bye.
I would have never known if you wouldn't have told me. I'm glad.
I know. It was so realistic.
It's very realistic. You look good with the mustache. You should... Think about always having.
Think about you. Maybe I will. You know what is your take on people using this and like singing along to Miley Cyrus? If they upload that to YouTube, would you take it right down?
That is a good point.
I told her that we wouldn't record it because.
Easily get flagged. Unless if somehow the karaoke stuff, like I bet you money that what the app does is allows you to share it within the app. So you can link to someone outside the app. YouTube, you're right. That would get content ID flagged quickly. Unless if somehow they changed the song to not be exactly the song.
You know what? I don't know if this changes anything because I was thinking, wait a minute, how are they going to make, $25 is pretty reasonable. And then I noticed that there's a TV commercial for it called, I think it's called buyselfiemic.com. And there it's $30 with free shipping. But in the guy says, and comes with bonus coins. So evidently, I guess you buy each song.
Oh, that might make sense. Here's the
make your own real music videos with the all new
kind of loud. Sorry,
I can't.
That's okay.
You sing, rock, and dance your way into your own real music videos, just like your favorite stars. It's easy. Just download the free Star Maker app, attach your smartphone, and you're ready to rock.
We're gonna get content ID claim for that song.
Shake that.
Choose from thousands of songs made famous by Taylor Swift, Justin Bieber, Drake, Ariana Grande, and many more. Extend your selfie mic to record a group video or bring it in close for your solo performance. You'll sound and look like a star with special audio effects like auto-tune and cool filters that will make your video shine. Follow the karaoke lyrics on screen and you'll never miss a beat or a word. Then share with your friends with just one tap. How easy was that? Selfie Mic works with a free downloadable Star Maker app and comes with everything you see here. Plus, you'll get Star Maker bonus tokens. Just $29.99 with free
shipping. Bonus tokens. Right. So if they charge like 99 cents a song.
Right.
Do you think that would cover the letting you put it on YouTube?
No.
Definitely not.
Yeah, that would be, so I bet that you can use this within the app. They have some deal that it's only within the app. You can record a video, share it with your friends, but not on YouTube, like within the app maybe. I don't think you would.
Okay. But anyway, I think it's a fun thing for parties. I think kids will.
So, by the way, music labels are doing nowadays is they won't take down your video, but they will claim your video as theirs, and any ad revenue made off the video goes to them instead of you.
Oh, my word.
So there's actually a incentive for them for you to do that. Put up your video. Who cares? We'll put ads next to it. If it becomes popular, we'll make the money off of it.
Wow. Yeah. Last month, I think one of my videos made 87 cents. I could be out 87 cents.
That cents is gone. I mean, that'll take your cents. Yeah.
Got to rethink my income
your strategy there. You might not become the next YouTube star.
No.
Yeah, based off of that. Yeah.
So it's a fun thing. It's going to be in stores for $25. That commercial thing you saw, it's $29.99. And I looked for a copyright thing, and the commercial is copyrighted by Moose Toys, which owns this device. So they evidently are, for the extra $5, they're shipping it free and giving you some bonus tokens to download some songs. And hopefully there are some public domain songs on that list that you can just
Bleak is saying because it's a MIDI version of the song, which you can sing over, which is protected by fair use. But there's a few problems with that. A, fair use does not mean that you have to claim that your thing is fair use. They'll still say that's mine and it is theirs. It is their copyrighted material. Fair use is a way to negate that, and you have to claim it as fair use. It just gets complicated. So
yeah.
I don't know.
Well, so I thought fair use was 10 seconds.
There's different things for radio. Radio has some options that they could play a song for a certain amount of time, but that is not, no, like if you're using a song not in a potential of critiquing the song or reporting on the song, even for less than 10 seconds, if you're using it to spice up your video, that's still considered copyright infringement. So there's, I mean, it just gets so complicated because there are so many carve-outs for different industries that you might think applies to YouTube, but it doesn't. Oh, and there might be things that apply to YouTube, but you have to go after it yourself. You have to report the claim and say, you know what, this and this and this is fair use. And you have to, it just gets so complicated.
I just stay away from it.
Stay away from it, really.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the easiest thing to do. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, so, yeah. Okay, well, that is that. She said 25 on the website. It looks
like 25 in stores.
In stores.
And at the selfie TV
selfie
thing.
Mic. Yeah.
It's $29, but it gets free shipping and you get some tokens for some free songs.
Right.
So it's probably about the same.
That's cool because, we just saw that other microphone just a few episodes ago that was the same selfie microphone, but this one's like more for karaoke, more for fun.
Yeah, exactly. And it's built into the selfie stick.
Right, exactly. Okay, moving on. Well, there's no ad on this.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for...
But you might want it at Chad's Crappy Clothes. get it.
Okay, so we are in Bluetooth month. This is actually the last Bluetooth gadget that I'll be showing off. We've done a lot of gadgets so far that have microphones built in. We did, you know, the watch, the glasses, the gloves. And so I wanted to do a Bluetooth gadget that didn't have anything to do with voice calling. Nothing
or Bluetooth.
To do with, or Bluetooth. We got rid of the Bluetooth. Completely different gadget. No. So I've been using for a long time a tracker. So before we get into what this gadget is, I want to show off what the competition is like to kind of set the standard for what I was hoping that this would do. And I've been using a product called Tile. It's a tracker so that whenever I lose whatever the tile is attached to, I can find it easily. It works in a few different ways. Either from my phone, I can go into the Tile app, and let's bring that up, and I can call, that is out of focus. I can call my keys and hit the button, and my keys will start making a little sound.
Okay.
And then I can hit done from within the app, or if I hit find and they start going, I can, there's a little button within the E of the Tile, and I can hit that button, and it'll shut up. It'll stop. It'll stop making its little sing song. Or from the keys, let's say I need to find my phone. This phone is locked. I'm also going to set this phone into vibrate mode, so you can see that I am turning off the ringer. It's on silent, and I can double tap the Tile, and it will call my phone. And so this sound is now coming through the phone, and when I unlock my phone, well, normally there's a little thing, and if I go in, it stops. The notification is done. So it's really cool. So from either the phone, I can call the keys. From the keys, I can call the phone, even if the phone is locked and silent. On top of that, Tile has a community, so if you lose your keys far, far away, let's say you leave them in a different city at a bar, you don't know where they are, you can claim that they are now lost beyond what, this is all connected through Bluetooth, so if it loses its connection from Bluetooth, lost beyond my Bluetooth connection, far away.
If there are no walls or anything, it's 100 feet, right? With
I'm amazed by how far, this will be in my garage or on the second floor of my house in the kitchen somewhere completely far away from my phone, and I'll call and it'll make the connection. I'm amazed at how far the Bluetooth signal works. So let's say that you lose your keys in a bar, and obviously you're miles away now. You can claim it as lost, and the whole community of Tile users will basically, the apps will be alerted that they're looking for this specific Tile. If it's ever found, it will alert you with a pinpoint about where your keys are. So it'll give you like a radius of like, we found the Tile community has found your keys at this around this area, so you can go back and try to find your keys. So these guys cost what is the cost of a Tile? It's not crazy expensive, but it's also not cheap at the same time.
Yeah, you know, I saw that at a show, and the one thing that I was not crazy about is they're only good for a year, right?
Right. So, and there's no replaceable battery. It is. You can't open it up and replace the battery. When this dies, you're expected to buy a new Tile. It's $25 for a single Tile, but they have these bundle packs where if you get four Tiles, you'll save 30%. So it's only $70. For four, so that brings it down below $20 a Tile. Or if you get eight tiles, it's $130. So they kind of hope that you're gonna buy a whole bunch of them and then maybe give them to your friends or something like that. So
Also, you know, at one point they were talking that they might sell you you might send that in and get a new one for half price.
That's actually true. Yes. If you have one, you can. It's basically recycling it, and you do get a price reduction. So it has its pros and cons. I do think that it's a little bit overpriced for what it is. It's also pretty large. So anyway, when looking for Bluetooth gadgets, I found competitors. This is a competing product. Let me make sure I call it what it is called on Amazon. This is the Smart Bluetooth Tracker GPS Locator Tag Alarm Wallet Key Pet Dog Tracker. So it basically does the same thing. Now, right off the bat, there was a little bit of weirdness because on the Amazon page, it said that I needed an app called iTracking, but on the actual thing, it says iSearching is what I needed. On top of that, when I looked for the iSearching application, all of the screenshots in iTunes and all the description is in a language I don't know. It's obvious. It's some type of Chinese or character language. I'm gonna show my ignorance if I try to actually claim what language this is in because I'm just not sure. So that scared me that I wasn't gonna be able to operate the application. Luckily, when I downloaded iTracking, it was able to be correct and in my native languages as devices and
what is
like
your
that.
Native language?
English, luckily.
Oh,
and,
okay.
And
good.
That's actually my second language. You know, I mean, being a dyslexic, you basically have no native language at all. So there you go. So the app actually ended up working just fine. I found it was iSearching is what you're using. So. Based off of, what I know with Tile, if I hit the alarm right here, it should beep my keys. And there it goes. Oh. It's beeping the keys. Now, my first impression is that I could, because what happens when you find it, you hit it and you push the button to stop the beeping, but that actually doesn't stop the beeping. So if by accident you locked your phone, now you have to go back in and unlock it and then hit cancel alarm from within the app. You have to be within the app to turn off the beeping.
So what happens, Chad, if your phone is in another county? Does that ring until the battery dies?
Basically, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, basically. So, yeah, you're absolutely right. We'll get to that in just a second.
Okay.
Alternatively, you can double-click the tracking device, and it'll ring your phone. Remember, my phone is in silent mode, and there it goes. So it actually does break through the silent mode.
Wow, okay.
But this is the sound that it plays. Birds. Which I gotta say is like the quiet, out of all the sounds that you could have added, is probably the quietest sound that I could possibly think of is birds chirping. Now, once again, you have to go into the app to turn off the bird chirping. So, whoops, sorry, I didn't mean to go. So I have to turn it off in here. I can't just, like, double-click this again to turn it off.
Okay.
So that's kind of a little bit annoying. Now, if the two of these become separated for whatever reason, and I'm not actually sure if I can do this, turn off my Bluetooth and they become disconnected. This has happened a few times where I've left this in the kitchen and I took my phone with me. It's doing it. So it's lost connection. So not only does this start to beep, but my phone will also start making the chirpy chirp sound that it's lost connection. So both of these have separated and they will both start to beep. And that is the thing, is because you can only turn off the beeping from within the app. If you accidentally leave this behind at your home and go to the store or whatever, whoever's at home is now left with a beeping device that they can't unbeep. It'll just continue to beep until it runs out of batteries.
Which could be days.
Could be days, right? On top of that, I forgot to mention that when it came to me, it was dead. It comes with a battery, and the battery was dead. It was already not working. So.
Oh, you know why? It probably got separated from the factory and started beeping.
I guess. Yeah, exactly. Right. It started beeping in the package. So you have to buy. I had to go and buy one of these, you know, slim batteries.
Oh, 2032s.
What is this one?
Oh,
3232. The 2032, yeah, CR 2032.
I buy them by the box because they're very popular.
Yes, absolutely. So I had to go and buy one of those batteries in order to make sure that it would work. So those are my problems with the device. Now, that being said, it is only $5.99 versus the $25 which the Tile costs. Now, of course, there's no app ecosystem where the community will find your device if it is lost, other than the community close to you, because they're annoyed that there's a beeping sound that they can't turn off from the device. It also,
I think your community would be your cats.
Exactly.
Trying to find out where those birds are. Okay. Whenever you see the cats charging into a room looking for birds, you know your phone is there.
I go, that's where I left my keys. That was the first thing that jumps to mind. The other thing is that there was something else I was going to say, but I can't remember.
How were the reviews?
Not good. Now, well, okay, so the one that I bought, the product reviews are not fantastic. They're at 1.5 here. But I was looking around Amazon when searching for this product, and there's a lot that have fantastic reviews. So these are all, you know, different apps. Well, that was $62. Well, that's not
the $62. One I was looking at.
But this, like, let's say this one's $20, you know, these all had pretty good reviews. So I kind of had a suspicion that this was actually going to end up being a very good, gadget, for the cost, but that didn't happen. I can't even get this to connect.
Yeah, you'd have to literally throw it away. Oh, well, actually, you'd have to find and take the battery out, basically.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, the last thing that I wanted to say is, if let's say you're in a bar, okay, out in public, and right next to you, you hear this sound. What's the first thing that jumps into your mind?
Smoke detector?
That's a bomb! Does this not sound like a bomb about ready to detonate? Am I the only one who would think that?
Okay. Wow.
Cancel. Anyway, I have a few problems with the tracking device. So, but if this sounds like your cup of tea, it is only $5.99. It was Amazon Prime when I got it. So it was quick. It came in fast. And that's it. See, Radio
Still
Rod
is.
Got it. Radio Rod thought it was a bomb. Yeah. So for this, I would say don't buy. Don't buy. This is an actual crappy corner. Sometimes our gadgets are cool.
Oh, listen,
and you like
I think
them.
Like five people in the chat room, including me, bought those glasses that
right?
you have on.
Sometimes you swing and you miss, and it is a crappy gadget. So. That is my crappy corner for this week. By the way, if you are a patron, don't forget to check very quickly, very soon, for our next theme. I'm going to be putting up a straw poll, a poll on what the next gadget theme should be. And I think there's some cool ones that is going to be in there. I think the one I'm most excited, I'm not telling you to vote for this one. You vote for whichever one you want to. But I think I'm going to put smart home in there. I think that's going to be a pretty good one. Okay, moving on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are. gadgets pass away. He takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse
Foghorn.
And our letter says, hi, Dick and Chad. Here's a video I made for the Giz Wiz showing off my first cell phone. If you choose to show it, no compensation is needed because I already have the mad goodies.
Ooh.
Have fun. Oh, it's from Conky. Conky, who is a big fan of the show. And I think he actually also won the What the Heck Is It game, I think. And that's why he already has the current mad and Alfred E. Newman picture. But let's take a look at Conky's Gadget Warehouse.
Hey, Dickie D and Chad.
Hey!
Just wanted to show you one of my old gadgets. This is my first cell phone. I bought this in 1993. And most people refer to these as brick phones. But Motorola called it a Dynatac.
In 93, I would have
produced
been 4 years old.
1984 to 1994. And when they first came out, they cost $4,000.
Whoa!
This one was at the tail end of production and was already being phased out. I think I picked this up for around $300. I'm not really sure why I saved it, since it won't work on any cell network available anymore. But this is what it looks like. This is
the
car charger or the car adapter. It doesn't actually charge, it replaces the battery. This is the phone itself. You can see why they call it a brick phone.
That's without the battery.
Yeah.
And, these things were pretty basic. All they
battery
did was
looks like a magazine.
Receive and place phone calls. No SMS. The first ones were 2.5 pounds, but this one is pretty streamlined, as you can see.
That is a real antenna.
But it's small enough to fit in me lady's purse.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like. The batteries were NiCads. This thing would provide 30 minutes of talk time.
30 minutes?
My God.
Oh, it still turns on. It's been in my attic for 20-something years.
Wow.
That phone even has battery.
It went on, and it's in low battery.
Probably better than
it's
what
20
most,
years, turkey, low battery.
Lithium ions will do these days.
Wow.
Here's the charger. Probably the,
holy cow,
the first wireless charger, since USB didn't even exist. So that's it. Motorola Dynatac.
That phone's so old it probably gets a dial tone. Oh, yeah. My gosh. That is amazing.
Conky, that is a great video. Conky, in the chat room, he said, "Wait, I bought my Mad stuff." Well, Conky, October Mad's coming out. In 10 days. So shoot me your, if you live in the U.S. or Canada, shoot me your email address.
Could I have you vamp about something real fast while I run downstairs and get something?
Sure.
I have something that I'd love to show off. Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay, very good. So Conky, send me your mailing address and you'll get October Mad. It's coming out like August 10th. And you'll get one of those Alfred E. Newman pictures. Like I said, if you live in U.S. or Canada. And we're looking for more videos. Fortunately, I think we have at least two good videos in the works, or in the warehouse, rather, or warehouse videos that we can use. We still need some letters. Letters of the day would be good, especially if you want to write about something we talked about and you bought and your experiences with it. I know Becky said she bought the glasses, the FM glasses. And they got hot while charging, and she said, really, really hot. So Becky should send us an email and tell us if they still worked after they charged. I also bought the glasses. The glasses are pretty neat.
All right, I'm back.
Okay.
So what I wanted to show you was something that my father gave me when I was there last. This is a phone from my great uncle. And so first... Conky's phone kind of reminded me that that I have it. So this, first let's just show off the box. This could replace the letter if we wanted to, I don't know. We have, you could save all those steps with a handy extension telephone. One of my favorite things is modern homes have several phones.
Wow.
This phone is built like a tank. I mean, this
it's like one of the original Bell phones.
Absolutely.
Right?
So
it's Bakelite, I think.
Is that what the is that what it's made
out of? I think they were made out of Bakelite, which is like this heavy duty, almost unbreakable.
So it has some numbers on here, Smith Haven, and the phone number is M12-8921. That's the entire phone number.
So that might be from England then.
You
right?
know what? No, this is from my
your father actually your grandfather used
it? This is my uncle would
your
have
uncle?
Used it. So there's some numbers for some services, ambulance, doctor, police. It's MI 53000 would be fire department. MI 52640. And what they were, what my mother explained was that they were for areas, because you would call and you would say I want, say the Arbor area. So this was basically the area code, is I need Arbor, 33000, and that sort of stuff.
I'm surprised they had curly cords back then.
I know, right? I don't know if this even. It's plugged in. It's not like a normal. It's just always on, and in there.
Okay. And how would it connect to a landline? Is there any connection? Is it be hardwired to the?
I guess I would. You'd use this little.
Oh, that area. Out. Yeah. Is that a battery in the bottom?
I'm not
what
sure.
Is
I mean, this thing is very, very heavy. It has an area to
wow
to hold that. London Burton Funeral Home, apparently. I'm not sure. But yeah, so very, very old phone here. And just the box that it came in is just so funny.
Oh, it's great.
I just love the modern homes have several phones.
Several phones. Who would have thunk?
Type 80 desk telephone. Automatic Electric is the creator. Anyway,
that's
North
pretty
Lake.
Neat.
Yeah.
Pretty
so anyway, neat. That I wanted to show that off while we're talking
yeah.
about.
Yeah. Someone's
phones.
Asking what the phone number was on it.
The phone number on here would be MI 2-88 8921.
Okay. I think your uncle might have been a spy because MI isn't MI the, like London's
yes. MI,
FBI.
MI6, yeah.
MI6,
MI5, yeah.
And he was MI5, so he was even more important than MI6.
Exactly, exactly.
Wow.
So that
wow.
is this telephone. I think that it also works. This is how you'd put that up. Something like that.
Oh, okay.
Very crazy. So very old telephone from my family.
Great.
Wait, do we want to move on to a letter?
Yeah, we're going to move on to a letter. But don't forget, we're still looking for videos and we're looking for letters. Everything goes to mail@gizwiz.tv. And if it's a video and we show it, you'll get whatever the current issue of Mad Magazine is at the time and one of those 28 to 30-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. mail@gizwiz.tv. Make a little video, 2 to 3 minutes. Put it on YouTube. Click unlisted so that only us or anybody you send the link to can watch it. And hopefully you'll see it here on the Giz Wiz. And if you have any comments about the show or gadgets, we definitely need letters to read. We need one for next week.
Perfect. Moving on to the letter.
Here come the letters. I thought the lovely letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters now. Here come the Giz. I said the Giz Wiz letters now.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is an email from a press person, and I thought I would refer to it because maybe we have another event for you to go to, Chad. It's from Alex Verrey, V-E-R-R-E-Y. It's a press invite to meet YouTube's biggest gaming celebrities.
Exciting.
You know what? Are you a gaming celebrity or are you a gaming host celebrity?
I have been called both. I don't know about the host celebrity. When I just went to some hospital stuff and they were like, gaming celebrity, Chad is here. And it was like, I don't know if I'm quite celebrity status yet.
Okay. Well, this is being put on by Endemol, the world's largest TV production company in the world, it says. And it's called Legends of Gaming Live, a spectacular two-game event. Actually, it's in London. On September 10th and 11th, we are providing food and drinks. I guess that means your own airfare.
Are you providing airfare?
And hotel. But I thought this was interesting. It said that it's a very long thing. But anyway, the basis is among young people, YouTube gaming celebrities are more important than TV, movie, and recording stars. Have you found that? Are you mauled when you go to these events?
Yeah, depending on the event. I mean, when I went to MineCon, which is the convention that I'm probably going to be the most recognized at because it's all about Minecraft, I literally needed security with me to otherwise.
Are you serious?
Yeah. The first day I walked onto the floor just to walk around. I've been to many conventions where, it's not a big deal at all. But at MineCon, most of my con is about Minecraft. So it's the concentrated, situation there. And so I'd get stopped by one person for an autograph. Someone would get behind them, and soon I'd have a big line. And security they came up and was like, you can't do this. They were mad at me. They thought that I had planned like a meetup or something. They're like, you can't sign here. There's too many people in your line. This is a fire hazard. And so after that, they made me walk around with security, and security would be like, go to his signing at 3, like, stop,
Wow.
Like, it was intense. It was the first time that the, celebrity status was almost like an issue that I couldn't act normally. Luckily, mm-hmm. at most conventions, it's not like that at all. It's very chill. I just walk around like normal, and then maybe every once in a while someone will recognize me and come up and say hi, and I get to spend as much time as I want, just talking to them and stuff like that. Back to the point of gaming personalities and people who are on YouTube are more important to kids than anyone on TV. Absolutely. If you look at anyone from 7 to 16, and you look at their consumption habits, it is all on their phone, on their tablet, on their computer. None of them are sitting down and watching TV, especially that 7 to like 13-year-old age.
Right.
All of them are glued to their phones or iPads. And they're watching YouTube, and they're watching that type of content. That is their celebrities, is the people that they watch. I mean, that's all celebrity is how much time you've spent with someone, virtually, is how much time have you spent watching them and idolizing what they do and who they are. That's all celebrity is. And to them, to a younger generation, that is absolutely their Tom Cruises. Their, the most famous people are internet people. So, yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's actually kind of scary because a lot of the celebrities they don't take that responsibility as important and as significant as it should be. they think, oh, I just put videos online. It's like, you are a role model. You are, you know, you are teaching these kids what's right and wrong, you know, and a lot of internet celebrities don't see that, I think.
Yeah, no, you do. I know when you first took over the show, you was asking if I could call you Mr. Johnson.
Right. Yeah.
And, I mean, and I was saying, you know,
Prince,
I,
it's now Prince. If you could call me Prince Johnson.
Prince Johnson.
Yeah, that's my kingdom.
But it is funny because, like with Leo, when I was, this is now like 3 or 4 years ago, when I was in Petaluma and we go to lunch or something, not one head turned. But walk down the hall with Leo at CES.
Oh, yeah.
You can't move 3 feet because
absolutely.
Of the crowd's gathering.
I
so
mean, that's it, really what conventions are all about is, yes, is distilling yes. the amount of people. Yeah, at MineCon, it is a legitimate problem for me to walk amongst, you know, yep. everyone. But I work at PAX where I'm actually hosting, and it's not a big deal at all, you know. So, yes, absolutely.
Very interesting.
Absolutely.
Anyway, so that will, so we didn't need to letters for next week. That was our last letter that we have here on file. And I guess we have wrapped up this show.
Woohoo!
Right?
Yeah. Big thanks. Don't forget that if you want to be part of the decision process for next month's gadget, become a patron of our show.
Yes, save us.
Over at patreon.com. That is the place. Patreon, if you don't know, is a place for you to support independent content creators like ourselves. So head on over to patreon.com/gizwiz. Oh, it's not loaded yet. There we go. That's our site. That's our page. And please become a patron of our show. We would super duper appreciate it. And we thank all of our current patrons so much for making this show possible. Without you, we wouldn't be here. So thank you so, 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 so much. Also, you can catch the show live. Oh, did you have something to add to it?
No, I just...
He's
just
all choked up,
something.
Folks.
I'm all,
all choked
hey,
up.
Please.
So you can watch our show live at 7:30 Eastern time, about 7:30 Eastern time, 4:30 Pacific time, at gizwiz.tv. You'll see the live stream right there. If you come in a little bit ahead of time, it'll be here. It'll be blank. There'll be a countdown. And you can also join our chat room right below it. We love it. Seeing people in the chat room right now. We got 73 people in the chat room. Fantastic that you're here, and our schedule should be pretty solid
next week. After we'll be back at our normal times. It's wonderful.
So please check out the show live. You can also subscribe on iTunes, on YouTube. We got HD, SD, and audio versions for the
Diamond
RSS
Club.
Podcast. You can watch on Diamond Club. All sorts of places to enjoy the Giz Wiz, or just on our site with show notes and links back to all the products we talk about, and also links over to gizwiz.biz. By the way, pro tip, if you want the product, you can click the link, but if you want the write-up that Dick has done, click the name of the gadget. So if you want to see the Gourmet Tea and Coffee Center, click on that, and you'll be sent to gizwiz.biz. And while you're at gizwiz.biz reading up on all the cool gadgets, check out What the Heck Is It? It's the game show. No, it's not really a game show. It's the it's the gadget that you gotta figure out what it is and guess along with everyone else. This is the this bi-monthly guessing game right here. It's pretty obvious to me that this is a utensil for Doritos, specifically made for Doritos. You know, you got it's a Dorito scoop, basically, right into your mouth.
Could be.
So if you want to guess, head on over to gizwiz.biz. There are 12 Mad Magazines, the October Mad Magazines, right? The October ones?
Yep.
Correct answers, but 24 for funny, hilarious, incorrect answers. For the funny and creative answers that you send over. So please participate. in What the Heck Is It? That about wraps it up for our show. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next week.
I'll be here.